Blackstone presents Banvard's Folly, Revised Edition, 13 Tales of People Who Didn't Change the World, by Paul Collins. This book is read by Tim Getman. This book is dedicated to past collectors of curiosities: Isaac Disraeli, Edmund Pearson, John Timms, and to any publisher who puts their works back in print. Have you heard it was good to gain the day? I also say it is good to fall. Battles are lost in the same spirit in which they are won. Vivas to those who have failed, and to those whose war vessels sank in the sea, and to those themselves who sank in the sea, and to all the generals that lost engagements, and all overcome heroes, and the numberless unknown heroes equal to the greatest heroes known. Walt Whitman, Song of Myself. Preface. There used to be a vintage shop in my old San Francisco neighborhood that kept a bin of ancient black and white studio portraits. Stiff Victorians and sly flappers, tintypes and cabinet cards, aunties and sweethearts, all heaped under a hand-lettered sign that announced, "Buy yourself some relatives." When patrons spotted it, there'd be a split second of bewilderment, then a burst of shocked laughter. Most moved on quickly, but a few would pick up the photos and gaze into them. The same questions always hung in the air. Who were these people? How were they forgotten? But then, if you peruse the documents of any past era, you find almost nothing but forgotten names. A famous name brings a jolt of recognition that in these crowds of nobodies, and once were somebodies, is a person that you can attach a face and a reputation to. The collector values those rare documents. But I always found myself wondering about the other people, the ones in the junk store photos. Buried in these footnotes of history are brilliant, fatally flawed thinkers who sometimes rose to dizzying heights, only to come crashing down into disaster, ridicule, or just the utter silence of oblivion. Occasionally, I'd find others who shared my predilection for the ephemera of forgotten genius. In the early years of the internet, I often found myself drawn to the Dead Media Project, devoted to the numerous experiments that died on the barbed wire of technological advance. The Edison kinetophone, Gaumont's chronophone, the synchronoscope, the movietone, phonofilm, the graphophonoscope, the vitaphone. The chroniclers of such innovations are all curators at heart, I suppose, of items that we fear no one else will have time for. Why write about such things, you may ask? And if it's not you, surely someone will ask this question. The man or woman of promise who has nothing but excuses and regrets to offer at the end of the day. These people, we do worse than despise. We avert our gaze and excuse ourselves from their presence. But for each person with a winning innovation to their credit, there are the losers who pursued a similar path to failure. Perhaps their timing was wrong. Maybe they lacked the ruthless force of personality that propels the winners of history. Sometimes, they were simply undone by weaknesses that had little to do with the merits of their ideas. Or they truly were just plain wrong, but with a fervor as great as anyone who ever got it right. And so, I began this book, an account of those who fell in their pursuits. Whole books could be unearthed on each of their lives. And I hope that happens someday. But for now, this small excavation may suffice. Banvard's Folly. The life of John Banvard is the most perfect crystallization of loss imaginable. In the 1850s, Banvard was America's most famous living painter, acclaimed by millions and by such contemporaries as Dickens, Longfellow, and Queen Victoria. His artistry, wealth, and stature all seemed unassailable. 35 years later, he was laid to rest in a lonely frontier town in the Dakota Territory. Nearly penniless.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.